for any report.
All right, welcome back to a new episode of Road to Show. Today's going to be a slightly different one to usual. It's going to be like a raw workout. I've got push day today. I've just had some like people just saying, can we just see your workout? Why I'm doing each exercise? Because a lot of people want to see how I grow my chest and whatever. So I'm just waiting for Leo at the moment. He's about to come through. And we're training at Absolute, which is more of the meathead bodybuilder gym. I was going to pick up some pre-workout before this from Dave, but Dave's at Nando's right now, so I'm probably going to get it after the session.
But
they do sell pre-workout gym, so I might just get a cup of their bullshit. No idea what is going to be in there. Probably absolutely horrible ingredients, but I mean, it's mainly just the ritual.
Change of plans. David had just said that he's going to swing around and drop the pre-workout over,
and it's the blue raspberry flavor, which is the brand new one that's not even released yet, which will be released pretty soon. Yeah, all the other flavors have been amazing, so I'm pretty gassed to try this one. So he's going to drop this around and we're going to see how this taste.
Your car, bro.
Huh?
Why have you got protein?
Okay, basically,
in your car?
I parked my car in a visitor space in my apartment building. It's been there for weeks. It's not allowed to be. You're only allowed 24 hours. So somebody's taken it to their own hands and thrown eggs at me.
This is my old car.
Oh my god. Thank you, ma'am.
Look at it.
That is beautiful. It matches my car as well. Literally, like, spacey spot on.
Yeah.
That looks sick.
Thank
you, bro.
Nice.
And it matches your top.
Yeah. And my joggers. Just really.
Anyway, lads, we've got some overdrive. This is the blue raspberry. This is a new flavor that's coming out. I don't know when it's coming out. Pretty soon though. Code Harley if you want to save some money. Me and him are also working on our own pre-workout, which will be a good few months down the line because we want to get it right. But that's definitely something to also look out for. We've got some chemist that's basically helping us formulate the whole thing and make it the most optimal shit ever.
But yeah, we've got Derek from All Plates Mod 8 UK version.
Yeah, look at your bald head just taking up the whole front.
Oh, sorry, bro.
There's no like comparable one to huge supplements wrecked and like gorilla mode. So that's basically what we want to do. I've always been searching for this sort of 8 grams of L-citrulline, just like maximum pump. Our chemist that's helping us out has actually found some ingredient that is similar to DMAA, but it's legal, bro. This is our chemist just doing his thing.
Just in the lab, bro. Just like
whipping up, bro.
Pouring things like this.
It's going to be a fucking epic pre-workout and I can't wait to try it myself. Can't wait to see it.
Yeah,
and
I'm so
can't
excited for
wait
that.
For everyone else to buy it and see where the shit is at, bro. Yes, for now, code Harley on overdrive. This is still amazing. I'll never put down this product. That's the most jacked taxi man I've ever seen. That looks like he's stolen that shit. Look at this.
He's gonna see this and be like, what the
fuck? It's the most jacked taxi man you've ever seen in your life. Don't see me. You got some pre-workout?
Huh?
Have you got some pre-workout?
Overdrive one,
yeah.
I'll see you have.
It's the new one.
What flavour is that? Blue raspberry.
Bro's about to dry scoop the new pre-workout and see if he enjoys it. This man's not sponsored, so this is going to be an honest review. I guess it's dry scoops anyway, so it'll probably taste like shit, but there you go. Bro, do you even have water in your mouth? Oh, okay.
That's good. That's good.
Just lagging. Pardon me.
Oh, I thought that was my phone.
So
I was like, oh god, mess. Oh!
Let's go!
No
bro,
way.
I just did a fart. I was like, and then Leo thought it was his phone, like a notification. Checks his phone, and he's got a bunch of Shopify orders that just come through.
Oh no, bro, that's my home screen.
Oh, I thought I farted, and then like loads of Shopify.
Imagine, that's the secret.
No, but he did.
Four sales.
He did actually get a message as soon as I farted.
Yeah. That's so funny.
All right, the pre-workout has been consumed, and I'm feeling tingly and ready to go. I haven't actually taken pre in quite a while, so I'm pretty gassed. We've got push day today. We're going to go pretty ham. It's going to be just like a raw workout. I'm just going to take you through it. Hear me talking about why I'm doing certain things and whatever. And just trying to educate you on this video a little bit. Let's get the fuck in there, bro. Oh, yeah.
Look at how bold I look in that light.
I mean, you are bold.
True.
That probably makes
look
sense.
How bold I look.
It's like, whoa, look
so
how bold.
Boldy.
Hey, guys. Just standing next to my best friend that I just pissed into. But it's a bit of a weird place to show you my fit. But I was going to do it earlier. So I'm sponsored by Gymshark now. So I just thought, let me promote my coat and show you some clothes that you might like. This hoodie right here. Look at that on the back.
Wait, lift the hood up.
There we go. I think this is called like the power zip up hoodie. We'll see this later. This is an element base layer. This is cheap as fuck on the...
Ooh, sorry, man.
Come in.
Oh, my God.
Bro, I was like, fuck that shit. This is the element base layer and it makes your boobies look really big and it's really cheap on the website. Like £18. So with code Harley, that's like 16 something, maybe. Who knows? And yeah, that's about it. And then I've got the sliders on as well.
Gymshark?
No, not Gymshark. These are just normal sliders. I'm just feeling like a bodybuilder. What bodybuilders do, they just wear sliders and they just walk around just absolutely fucking massive. And this is what this workout is going to be. Just me being massive. So yeah, let's go and train push.
Okay, so we're starting off with this little incline machine. I used to do this quite a lot. I haven't done it in a while. It's pretty busy, so most machines are taken, maybe what it could do. So this was free, and I know this is a good one. Upper chest, incline machine, go pretty crazy. That's about what I can say. Obviously, I'm no sort of like training expert. I've been training for like 4 and 85 years. So I've been training a while. Basically, when training chest, there's always focus on driving your bicep in towards chest. Don't focus on your hand, always your bicep coming in, and then you'll always get a better contraction. But yeah, that's my first little tip, bicep. Boss, the chest, man. This is probably going to be my top set. I've got 2 plates and a 15 on that. And we'll see how this moves. Obviously, I haven't done this in quite a while, so I don't really know what hype for. I'm going to aim for like 8 to 10 reps because obviously, it's a machine. It's pretty stable. So I can just focus on the muscle going to failure. So I can go a bit lower reps, if you know what I'm saying. Less chance of injury if you want to go lower reps. Do it on an exercise that's like safe. Yeah. Although, I actually don't really give a fuck to win this. Yeah, this might be a top set. It might not be. Let's try it out. With a backup set now, which is 2 plates and a 5. Obviously, that last set, my top set, I got like 7 reps, I think it was. So yeah, I'm just starting that as a top set. Now I'm going to get some more volume in, which is why I'm going a bit lighter. Most exercises now, I'm doing top set, backup set. Feel like spending heaps of the gym, making more of like the higher intensity. Not even low volume, because there's some sets where I'll go like 15 to 30 reps. I do like jog sets, supersets, or whatever. Once you've gone pretty hard on one exercise, I don't need to do like 3 of those top sets, which I just did. I'm gonna be training my chest at other points, so that's the idea with this one. Top set battle, yeah, that's about it. Alright, we're going optimal for the next 2 exercises. We're going in with the pec deck just to get like a mad fucking contraction. I go like 15 to 30 reps, so I go very high reps on this. 3 sets of that. Get a massive comp pretty much and like focus on the contraction. I usually use this exercise to then go into a press, just like a flat press, just to make that like really connect to my chest. Alright, so this is an exercise I haven't done before. My coach wants these deep wild old machines. This is just a blank press. I'm not sure how heavy it is, so we're just gonna test out a 20 and see how that feels. That's heavy. I'm going to do another set with this weight on the head that I just did. If I work on these wrist wraps, push myself a bit harder, I can still get like 10 to 12 reps maybe. I'm just going to do it again, but I think I can go harder than I did last set. This is your body. Your body thinks you can go heavy and go hard with like good form. For a second time, listen to your body and do it. And my body's telling me that I can do this weight again, even though it was hard last time, so yeah. There is a fucking crazy drop off on this exercise. It's like, you're banging them out. Once your muscle fatigues ever so slightly, it's just like it wasn't to anymore. But that was a good set still. I don't know, like 9 reps or something. So we'll take that. This is the last chest exercise we're gonna do. 3 for me was all you need. Was obviously go hard. 2 sort of pressing movements and then 1 fly. That's basically what you need for your chest. Basically, Samson Dowder. He's like a massive bodybuilder, like this year the biggest one at the moment. But I was like just watching his old videos because I went through like a rabbit hole the other day of just like watching these massive bodybuilders there from day of eatings, like in their off season. Anyway, I was watching him and in one of his workouts, he was doing these while I was just doing that. I actually fucked up your delt. Yeah, shoulders feeling nice and pumped up with that. We're gonna see how long this Gymshark Element base layer that you can use code Harney on takes to take off because it's clothing tight, bro. Took off earlier and it took a long time. Let's see. Oh, my motivation and tuning for means you know, take a bubble.
It's good.
We're onto shoulders now, just supersetting dumbbell lateral raises with these upright rows. It feels great, so that's the superset for shoulders. This is it for now. Right, so I just did like three sets of the superset, so basically 6 sets in total. That's basically what I need. If it's not a press, I basically just focus on getting a mad pump. So I'm treating it almost like a chest flight, where I use it just to sort of like go crazy on my delt before I go into a press. So now I'm gonna go into a shoulder press, shoulder exercise of choice. I'm not gonna go and sit on it because we're now, and that's gonna fuck up the audio for you lot. So I'm just gonna stand a bit of a distance away from it. I'm planning on just doing like a really heavy set and then just a drop set after that and then like finishing it there. Then moving on to triceps after. Got loads of volume on this one, just going fucking heavy. I'll probably set up the tripod on this one and get Leo to spot me. Make sure I get right to failure. Have nothing left in. That's the idea of this one. So you should listen to my advice because I've got fucking massive delts. I don't know if you knew, but yeah. I don't have massive delts, by the way. I was joking. You guys probably do actually think I have good delts. I personally think they're really bad. I think that's probably just from comparison to these people with like massive. Let's get the picture up. I'm gonna get the picture. We both know who we're talking about. Just from like just mentioning the word delt just triggers this man in my head. Boys are not even ready, bro. This is fucked. Oh my god, bro. Look at that. Due to comparison to people like that, I'm just like my shoulders are fucking dead. Go hard or go home. That's what they say, innit?
That was just stupidly heavy.
Yep.
Come on. harder. Oh my god. I'm gonna do another drop set.
So, quite a new exercise. We're just doing one tricep exercise, but we're making sure it's a good one. Double glizzy long row, it does feel great. As much hatred as I had to have towards Optimum Beagle. Double low rope row goes fucking crazy. It's basically all we need to one tricep when I get to my weight, three sets, 12 to glizzy reps. So, yeah.
Alright, I'm just doing this final set. This is my third and final set, and this is it for the workout. It's really quiet right now. We're literally like the last people in the gym. Kind of sexy though. I'm just gonna be hearing. I'm not even gonna listen to music, bro. I just wanna hear the
challenge.
Why do gyms play music, bro? That is the end of the workout, and that is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed my push workout, and I hope you gained something from it. That was pretty fun to film. Different sort of video. If you guys enjoyed it, then let me know. But your opinion won't change what I do. I just do what I want.